When you see this kind of circuit, two batteries, bunch of resistor or wire, and this galvanometer or ammeter, you should know straight away, oops, this is a potentiometer, potential divider kind of question. So we just stay calm and see what are we trying to find. So we have two cells, 6 volts, 2 volts. The resistance here is adjusted until the reading is 0. So reading 0 means it will point in a different direction. What is the resistance of resistor R? When it's reading 0, that means I can rub off that error because it's null anymore. The arrow shows where current is flowing. So current is not flowing. So I could draw a little arrow just pointing out here. Like that, long. So that means whatever current this primary circuit has, it will just flow through the top part only. Kind of like this. Okay. The bottom part, no current. So you can just write a reminder here, no current here. How do I know that? Because the galvanometer told me. Okay, how do we start? When you see potentiometer circuits, the first thing you want to know is, or remember, is if you have the battery down there in the secondary circuit, that means this PD is the same as the PD over here. Potential difference here is 2 volts. If down there is 2, up there is 2. Balance, ma. That's why no current will flow. Okay. So how are we going to find R? Just scratch our head a little bit. Never mind. Never mind. We stay calm. We have to use some potential divider ideas to help us out here. Okay. First thing I want to know, or I know that I know, is this. Can you find the potential difference there? If you recognize it, this is a loop. If you start from the battery, go through all these guys, and go through this one, and go back to the battery. So that means your 6 volts will be the 2 volts plus that missing resistor 3. Just give the numbers 1, 2, and 3. So what would V3 be? 6 minus 2, 4. 4 volts. So this is 4 volts. Well, one step closer now. So what if I use ratios to find the ratio, find the total combined resistance of 1 and 2. Let's try that out. So I'm going to use ratio. It's our best friend to help us find. It's like solving a puzzle, guys. So what is the resistance? What is the resistance of 1 and 2 combined? So I'm going to take the ratio of these two against this. So the ratio of the combined over 10 ohm equals 2. The potential of the combined section, which is 2 over 4. Okay, so that will tell me that the combined resistance of 1 and 2 will be 5. Right? 5 ohm. Does that make sense? You look and see lah, okay? If this is 4 volts and this is 2 volts, it means the resistance has to be half of 10, so 5 ohms. Can? Fair enough. Now, the 5 ohms is for 2 of these guys together. This one I don't know. This one I know is 2. So, 5 ohms will be R plus 2, and therefore R will be 3 ohms. So, this is one of the shorter ways to do it, but yes, you can find R is 3 ohms down here. Hey. So the whole idea of this question is, you know that 2 volts equals to 2 volts in the primary section here and down here. And from there, you have to figure out what information can you dig out or calculate or find from the whole circuit. Okay, go try out more questions about potentiometers. If you're not sure where to find them, you can go down to the description. Click on the hashtag for potentiometers and you will see other questions that's similar to this one. Okay? So that's all for this question. See you in the next one.